Let's try cross-tabbing in Alteryx, but before we do this, let's count the schools by zip code and level description to see what that would look like in the Summarize tool. When we look at the result, we can see that the data is showing counts of schools by zip code and by level description. But what we're trying to achieve is to create new fields out of the level description values that count the number of schools in each of those categories by zip code. To do this, we'll use the crosstab tool. After attaching the crosstab tool, we'll set it up. The group data by these values represents what we want to see at the record level. In this case, it's zip codes. The new column headers represents the fields that will be created from the values in that column of data. So if we want to see one field for each level description, then we select Level Desk here. Next, in the values for new columns, we need to select a numeric field so a count can be generated for each of the records. We'll select Enrollment. In the method for aggregating values, we'll select Count Without Nulls, which counts the number of records without null values. The end result have the level descriptions listed across the top and the zip codes along the side, along with the individual counts of schools that fall in each of these categories. We can easily remove the count prefix in the Select tool. We select the fields that we want to remove the prefix for. Go to Options, Remove Prefix, and select Remove Count Underscore. When we run the workflow, we can see that word count has been removed from the fields.